I'm Cara Page. I'm the creative and marketing director for Blogalicious. Stacey could not be here today, but she sends her love to everybody, and she's watching anxiously on Insta Stories and Facebook Live and every other platform that we use. So she's excited, and she says hello to everybody. I just wanted to thank you all for coming, and I wanted to thank Coca-Cola for sponsoring this amazing event and for being a true friend of Blogalicious. So let's give them a round of applause. Giannis, you know you can't escape this microphone.
Anything for you.
Come on up here. I want Giannis to say just a few words about Coca-Cola. She's going to share with you some of the tabletop vignettes that you guys see, the little scenes that you have on the high top tables, and talk to you just for a moment about Coca-Cola.
A very brief moment.
Very brief moment.
Hello, everyone.
Hey. How are you feeling? I see fans going, it is not that hot. You all look so lovely. Thank you so much for coming out. I know most of you are from here, but for those of you that are not from here, welcome to Atlanta, which is the hometown and headquarters for Coca-Cola. So I work at Coca-Cola. I'm in the public affairs and communications department, and we have sponsored Blogalicious for the last 4 years. And it has been an absolute pleasure and honor to work with Stacey and Cara and the entire team. They are one of the most well-oiled machines that I've had the opportunity to work with. So thank you guys so much for being great partners. So we know that this year's theme is Tribe Up. And so throughout this space, you'll see different vignettes which display different products that Coca-Cola has. So Coca-Cola, of course, is a global company, but we focus on our local communities, and we have beverages that refresh the world, of course, and we've been doing that for more than 130 years. We also have more than 200 brands to meet everyone's needs for different occasions. So we know everyone does not wake up early in the morning, go for a run, and decide to have a Coca-Cola or a Diet Coke. So we have Smart Water. We have Honest Tea, we have Vitamin Water, we have everything that you need to refresh you during any occasion, and so that is what these different vignettes represent. We also have different infographics on these tables as well to provide you with additional information about some of our products. So thank you again, welcome, enjoy.
Stacey Ferguson, who is here, she's right there. So let's all say, hey, Stacey!
Hi, Stacey!
Without going into too much detail, Baltimore Airport this morning, we had a TSA canine dog incident. And you know that there was some misbehavior this morning at the airport. And despite all of that, she didn't quite make it here. And we said, Stacey, it's fine. Your tribe is here. That's what this is about. It's handled. So we love you, Stacey. Tribe up.
Woo-hoo! Woo!
So, first off, welcome to Everywhere Agency. Blogalicious is truly, truly my tribe. And I know we're going to talk about that in a second. But it's a tribe that found me and has been so meaningful to me, so grateful to my tribe. I'm also, if I can just say, I'm a one percenter, which means I have been to every single Blogalicious since the beginning. Ever. So another tribe that's here is the Everywhere Society tribe, which is the tribe of amazing influencers that are using their voices in powerful ways. To share their personal stories, and so that's extraordinary. But I have to just take a moment, because speaking of tribes, the Greater Atlanta Influencer Tribe lost one of our dearest members in Anissa. And when we planned this event, we did not know that we were also planning it at the same time. It was just, it's the same time as her memorial service. So, if you did not know Anissa Mayhew, I'm going to say something about this OG of bloggers, the first. one of the first many of us ever met. She was an amazing author, a blogger, a comedian, a spirit, a woman who kept going despite two devastating strokes, the second of which left her partially paralyzed. She kept going when her daughter was diagnosed with cancer. She kept going when her marriage was threatened. She kept going through financial instability, through physical instability, and she kept writing. And she built a tribe, and she built a community, and she's extraordinary. So, Denene, who's also one of the earliest members of the blogging tribe in Atlanta, thought we would together share Anissa's mission statement, which is tribal in its very being, and hopefully will inspire us as we get started today. So, Anissa Mayhew's mission statement. Be thankful for something every day.
Do not take yourself too seriously.
Make a new friend or call an old one.
Play a practical joke on someone.
Laugh often, hug your family.
Swear frequently and adopt an animal.
Eat the desserts you love.
Drive your car like you stole it.
Business you've been talking about forever, and for goodness sake, quit the job you hate.
And finally, do not wait for life to find you. Live better, do better, have more fun doing it. Embrace life.
So let's all join for a moment, lift our hands, and lift up Anissa. Free at last, Anissa, free at last. So anyway, I guess I'll put it back to Cara, and let's think about the tribe we're going to build going forward.
Okay. And I also want to thank Danica and her team for hosting us for yet another fantastic event. She hosted us last year for our Atlanta pop-up. And your team is phenomenal. They take care of everything. We love you guys. We love partnering with you. So thank you, thank you, thank you. Autumn and Summer and Whitney, wave your hands in the air. I'd like you ladies to receive a hand clap from our audience. They have been working tirelessly to make this event special for all of us here today. So thank you all for that. And we're going to start our panel. And I'm going to introduce Precious Bivings. And she, if you want to come on up,
sure.
Coach P. She is actually our MC for Blogalicious this year, so we wanted you guys to get a preview of what to expect. So without further ado, our Tribe Up panel. Thank you, guys.
All right, so when she said I was the MC for Blogalicious 2017, y'all didn't make no noise. And I know y'all are lonely. So I think y'all make some noise about that. Y'all are like, listen, these ladies are intimidating. These are the ladies I'm gonna be when I grow up. Each and every last one of them. So I'm super duper grateful and excited to be here. I am affectionately known as Coach P. I drove here about 45 minutes ago from Greenville, South Carolina. Yeah, well, shout out to Greenville. So I am originally from here and Greenville. I'll explain how that works. So I was born in Greenville and raised here, Bankhead to be exact. So I have the best of both worlds. I come from corporate America and from a little bit of the hood too. So I have the opportunity to have all that good experience and I love it. So the most important thing that I heard today was about this beautiful, amazing woman so far, Anissa. Wow. When you get an opportunity to live a life that influences people, that they want to stop in their tracks and celebrate you, you've done your job. And so no matter what that is, make sure you take an opportunity for you to be that person in your own life, right? It doesn't have to be on a grand stage. It doesn't have to be being the president of the United States. It could just simply be being you. Because being you is where purpose starts, right? It's not about purpose being in a role or responsibility. It's about purpose being who you are. And then whatever role and responsibility you take on after that point becomes absolutely amazing. So are y'all ready to get this panel started?
Yeah.
Listen, I need some energy. Are y'all ready? expertly leading her own tribe that is impacting and influencing the communities around them for the better, which is just part of the reason why Blogalicious decided to ask them to participate in today's panel. They're also fabulous within their own rights as friends, mothers, CEOs, daughters, you name it, they're doing it. So I'm only gonna ask about three questions, but I wanna pass the mic to each of you ladies so that you can introduce yourselves and let everybody know what you're doing at supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. So I'll pass it to the lady of the house first.
I'm Danica, I'm the founder of Everywhere Agency, and I would say I'm building a tribe of girl bosses. Autumn, Summer, Milka, who are gonna kill it. Because I'm getting old. I'm getting old and better. So I'm really loving seeing how these girl bosses are taking off.
Awesome. Give her a round, guys.
Hi, I'm Denene Millner. I am the founding editor of MyBrownBaby.com. I also write books. And I have a new television show that I want all of you to watch on Sundays at 6:30 on Georgia Public Broadcasting called A Seat at the Table. And it's a show that was created with me, Monica Pearson, and Justine White, who's an attorney here. And we talk about everything you ever wanted to talk about as sisters, black women, talking about issues that affect us. So please tune in.
Round of
My name is Paulette Jewsome, and I work with the Coca-Cola Company, and I manage our blogger network for public affairs and communications. Right now, I'm just building a tribe of just phenomenal women that just represent all aspects of myself.
Yes.
Good afternoon, ladies, and a few gentlemen that I saw here who were brave enough to be out here on a Saturday. Bless all of you. My name is Alexis Davis Smith. I'm the president and CEO of Precise Communications. We are an Atlanta-based marketing communications firm. Coca-Cola is one of our clients. Always good to see my Coke buddies. And we have participated in Blogalicious for a couple of years, actually managing the sponsorship for Toyota. So I'm so excited to be here. To me, there is no better way to spend a Saturday afternoon with other women who are working and striving to make a difference in the community, and I am a firm believer that that starts with your tribe. If you don't have one, hopefully you'll build a strong one after you leave here today. So thank you, Cara and Stacy, for having me.
Yeah. Awesome. So shout out to the amazing, hey Stacy, hey! Of course, putting this whole thing together and going to pop up. I know you guys are going to several cities, so I was close enough in Greenville. I said, let me stop here, hop off 85. It was terrible, but you know what? We made it. And so I was glad for that. So shout out to the DJ. DJ Tammy's in the building. So there's a song that I typically start out with just to get everybody's juices flowing. Okay, everybody clear? Well, I want us to move a little bit, just a little bit. So can you drop that? But they also walk the walk. So the first question for the panel is, what does the word tribe mean, and why is it important to build one?
So for me, tribe is really all about community, and it's really important to make sure you're in the right tribe. So happens with communities, you sometimes fall into tribes. And you're part of a tribe. I don't mean to start with negative. You fall into a tribe. You're part of a tribe. But take a moment and step back and say, is this tribe supporting me? Does this tribe have my back? And if not, go out and build your own tribe. And also, sometimes tribes find you. Like I said, Blogalicious. I wasn't looking for that tribe. They found me, and they have supported and uplifted me. So I guess I'm kind of jumping ahead. Tribe is a lot of different things, but to me, it's really, it's not just finding a group of besties. It's more about finding a community that's supporting you on multiple goals. And also, I don't think there's any one tribe, you know? You got your fashion tribe, the shoes look okay, and they might be different from the gotta get my shit together tribe. The ones who give you what I call the 2x4 therapy, you know what 2x4 therapy is? And knocking my head with 2x4. That's a hard tribe, because you really don't like that tribe, because they're actually like, Danica, mm-mm. You don't want to hear that sometimes. So just, it's not always love in the castle with your tribe, but it's got to be supportive and uplifting.
When I think about tribe, I think about a community of like-minded individuals who come to a place and have the same kind of frame of reference. Not that we're all thinking exactly alike, but we kind of walk in with a frame of reference where we just get each other. And in that space, we get to use our experiences, our backgrounds, our expertise, our DNA to kind of shine a light on what it is that's important to us, the things that other people miss about us. I've built an entire career. I've been a journalist and writer since I was 17 years old. I got my first check. I'll be 49 in a couple of months.
Woo, woo.
So it's been 30 years. My math is horrible. But, but I can write. I can't add, but I can write. But I've built a career on shining a light on Black folks because I love us so. And in shining that light, I've managed to build a tribe that understands that we are so much bigger than pathology, we are so much bigger than negative, we are so much bigger than stereotype. And when you shine that light and you see the beauty of us, the tribe just grows. And so for me, tribe is shining a light. Tribe is, lifting up our importance and understanding that we have a place here. And that together we make that place insurmountable.
So for me, when I think tribe, I think more reflection. I think more reflection of who you are as a person, who I am as a person. I think that when I think of tribe, I think in terms of it being intentional. And not so intentional, as Danica mentioned. Sometimes you find yourself in a tribe. And I think that, but you have the opportunity to be intentional and to be, as we talk about, building that network of being around phenomenal women, to be able to engage those women, to be a part of something or to be a part of a group where you're able to reflect even those things that may not necessarily be you, that you may live vicariously through someone else, those things that you love about other people. I think that a lot of times those are when you think about your network, your tribe of people that you're with, a lot of times those are not so intentional, but they build on, you attract what you are. And so for me, I think that you have your intentional, you have your not so intentional, your intentional could be your professional. That convention. It could be what you do for your job, the projects that you take on. And so for me, it's more reflection. And just as you think about your tribe of people, think about how it reflects you and if it reflects you in the way that you want to.
I love this question, and it really, really made me stop and think. And I'll tell you when I was done, it also made me feel very grateful and blessed for the tribes that I do have. Because when I think of tribes, I think about historically, what did tribes used to look like? What did they stand for? And if you were a part of a specific tribe, you had pride in that tribe. Because tribes are usually people brought together, usually by family, and some aren't family, so it might be your friends, but they're brought together by a common interest, values. They're very loyal. They're strong. They stand together. They can have different opinions, but they still won't have each other's back. So to me, a tribe is really about a circle of common interest and loyalty, and again, standing for each other. So that could be your family. It could be your friends. As everyone said, it could be your work tribe. I have several. But I think while you do sometimes fall into a tribe, if the tribe is not for you, you're not going to stay in that tribe. Either you're going to leave or somehow you're going to get kicked out. Because it's not going to feel natural. To me, it feels like a sense of family and community because you know you belong there. And again, the loyalty thing to me is huge. If anybody follows me on Facebook, you see I say that for me so to speak. Loyalty is huge, and I think in your tribe, again, you will stand there for each other and you will fight for things together. Even if you might differ in opinion on small things, ultimately, I believe you have the same goal. So that's what a tribe is.
Awesome. Give our panel a round of applause.
The two words that stand out the most to me and everything that everybody said was growth and support. So if I'm in a tribe, then I know I can count on having growth and support. I'm going to have people that are going to challenge me, but that are also going to support me as I go higher. And so I want to pause. If anybody has any questions about tribe and any questions for our panelists so far? None? Is it good? Y'all get it? Yeah. Okay, good. I like energy back. That's all. I just like to come. Okay, so the next question is, how does your tribe impact the community around you?
So you're a reflection of the community you keep. You're a reflection of the community you keep. And there are some days I stop and I say, who's that community and how is it reflecting upon me? So there's probably one common denominator that I'm saying is to make sure that the tribe that you are surrounding yourself with is a reflection of who you want to be in the world. And it's very, I'm actually one of these people, I love everybody. I'm like a dog. You like me, I like you. This is a problem, because I will build tribes. But I've got to be very, very cautious and make sure that that tribe is a reflection of who I want to be in the world. So I'm always having to stop and take stock. Now, other people may be more discriminating than me, and God bless you if you are. It's taken me a while to get there, but it's very easy to fall into tribes. So just, to me, everything about the people that you're around is a reflection of who you want to be in the world. And so always, I actually now, in every, it's kind of drives me crazy, every conversation I'm having, I'm like, is this a reflection of who I want to be in the world? And if not, I find myself backing my way out of that conversation, trying to get out of there as quickly as I possibly can.
I'd like to think that the tribe that I built outside of my career, but specifically with My Brown Baby, so again, shined a light on us as Black moms and took, or tried to, and still a work in progress, tried to show us in a different kind of way versus the way that we typically see Black mothers presented in media in particular. My background is as a journalist. Worked for a very long time as an editor at Parenting Magazine and a columnist after I left there and moved here. And what I noticed in the parenting space was that we only talked about Black mothers when we were talking about something negative, right? Like, if you want to talk about poor educational outcomes, talk to a Black mom. If you want to talk about poverty or teen pregnancy, responsible black mom. And I'm a black mother, and yes, there are moments when I engage in those kinds of conversations, but that's not all that we are. We love our babies, we make them with intention. We love them with intention and abandon, just like any other human being does another human being that they created and carried in their womb or that came to them. I'm adopted, so I understand that you don't have to be carried in someone's womb to have a connection with them as a parent and child. But I'd like to think that My Brown Baby sort of created this space for us to be who we are in spaces where we don't necessarily get that kind of positive light shine on us.
So for me, it's gonna always kind of go back to intention, being intentional and always not saying intentional. And I would say, my grandpa used to have this phrase to always say, is class yourself and be by yourself. And, and create these intentional, intentional tribes we talk about, these tribes of women that we aspire to be, or the person that we aspire to be at some point. And so for me, I feel that I feel like my personal tribe, it affects my community in that it reflects how I give, how my attitude towards giving, how in terms of paying it forward, how mentoring people, or just how I give and how willing am I to be vulnerable to also receive those blessings that say other people, the people plant into your life and different things like that. So I think for me, it's more of is more being vulnerable, being able to give, being able to plant positive seeds, as well as being able to receive.
Well, again, thinking about the various tribes I have, but I want to think about one that is probably one of the strongest. I've said my family is the ultimate, but I want to think about or talk about my girlfriends here in Atlanta. We have a boy nickname, Best Girl Circle, and they're my daily tribe. And it's about 8 of us, all in our 40s, a couple are married, some are single, most of us are professional women, one's a doctor, one's a lawyer, like 3 or 4 of us are in marketing. And we all, again, have common interests and goals and values. But what I love the most about this group is that we inspire each other every day. And we lift each other up, and we know that we are going to be there to support each other. If somebody's at the hospital, somebody's running to the hospital to be with that person. If somebody's celebrating an anniversary for their business, like I did recently, they all showed up. That, to me, is about true friendship and standing by each other and supporting each other in good times and bad times. But the way that I think that we give back to the community is, again, we've come together on common interests that we all care deeply about our community, and we all give back to the community in different ways. Some of us do it civically. I think all of us are politically minded. Everyone does something in terms of community service. But what I hope that we give back, particularly to younger African-American women that see us individually or see us collectively, is inspiration. Because, on television, y'all, they act like women can't be friends.
Right. I know.
Especially black women can't be friends. And it's not true. It's not true. Probably all of us in here have really good circle of friends, good tribes, but they're not showing that. So hopefully, we're giving back to the community, particularly the African American community, in a variety of ways to make it stronger, because I think we all think about that on a daily basis. We text about it, we talk about it, we volunteer for things. So I think that's what we give back to the community, is really trying to inspire each other, and hopefully that has an effect, but to also actively be involved, to not just talk about it, but to be about it.
Awesome. Give them a round of applause.
So, I want to know from the audience, how many of us in the room outside of this amazing panel has tribes that they pour into, that they grow, that they cultivate. Let me see by a show of hands. Y'all lost your hands. Y'all like, my little, I got two people in my tribe. It doesn't matter, as long as it's a tribe. So tell me, I want to hear from two people, what do you bring? What do you bring to your tribe, and what does your tribe bring to the community? You got those beautiful glasses on, that hair is fire.
Introduce yourself.
Thank you. My name is Melody Stewart, and I'm a blogger. The Style Closet is my blog, and actually Closet is spelled K-L-A-Z-I-T, because it's different and I'm different. But actually, Corinne Charles, she is actually the person who has like really brought me into her tribe and has really grown me, and things that I thought I would never be able to do, like stand up and talk in front of people.
Awesome.
She has coached me, and it's like, don't say this, don't do that, and things of that nature. We're not that far apart in age, but I really look up to her. Not because she's taller than me, but because she has really poured into me and has really caused me to grow up and really see myself and see, that I'm really that girl.
Yeah.
So.
Awesome.
Yes, yes. Why don't you come up here? You raised your hand. Who's gonna argue when I'm the one with the microphone?
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Empowerment Coach Brandy, and my blog is Be Positive Media. And as far as talking about tribe, it was just kind of ironic because the person who did my blog consult for me when I started 2 years ago was the one who told me about Blogalicious, Ashley from Mommy Week. And so I built the blog, I was talking to other people, by myself pretty much for the past year and a half. And probably about 3 weeks ago, I said I wanted to expand the platform to people who might not be able to access some of the things that they wanted to access and didn't have a team per se, because this is my professional camera. And so I put it out there on Facebook, and so within 24 hours, we had 17 contributors. But what I love about it is that everybody brings their own mojo to the blog. We have veterans, we have special need moms, and the one thing that everybody has in common is that they just are tired of the news the way that it's coming out, like you were saying. And we just all want to vibrate higher, and so we're working together. Everyone is teaching each other. One of the requirements that I make is that they pull a post from somebody else on the blog every week and promote them. So we're all just working together, and it's a beautiful thing, because you know how, like, if you go to church and then you hear something that you just experienced? So when I'm hearing the word tribe, I'm like, we just did that. So I know that I'm supposed to be right here today. I almost forgot about the event. My daughter's at dance practice. But I came anyway, and I am so glad that I did, because we always said your vibe attracts your tribe. So I'm glad that I was able to GPS my way from Columbus and everything and all my way to here. So thank you guys, everybody. Be positive.
Thank you so much. She already came up here, and I have witnessed the chair. Yes, yes, yes. All right, so this is the last question. What about the Blogalicious tribe? Okay.
Sorry.
Sure.
Tribe matters, even if you don't realize you're reaching people.
Yeah. Oh my goodness. Yes. Awesome. All of us. any other, okay, then, come on. Give her a round of applause. Give her a round of applause, y'all. Come on.
So I wasn't going to say anything, but I really needed to just make sure I drove home the point with having multiple tribes. So I have several tribes, and some of my tribe people are in here. Veronica's husband is currently watching my children because I'm supposed to be at work. So Agatha brought me here. She's also a part of my tribe. I have my mom tribe who helps me out as a single mom. I have two beautiful children. I work full time. I own Happy Mango, which is a business that I'm at several hours a day. So I don't always have time to grab my kids. So I have my mom tribe. I have my blogger tribe who helps me out with the blogging that I never do, but like twice a month. I have my marketing tribe who helps me out when I have ideas. I bounce it off of them. Like, I have so many tribes, and they're so important. And sometimes they cross. Some people are in like four of my tribes. Some people are only in one because they don't play well with others, but they're all in their certain tribes. So it's really, really important for every aspect of your life to find one. Like, you have business mentors, you should have a tribe for everything. And it's just so important. So I wanted to just say thank you to my tribe members who are in here because I love you and I need you all the time. And that, yeah, multiple tribes are great. If you found one that works for you, you need another one. You need multiple. Like, they're great. You should have plenty. So.
Awesome.
Shout out to Facebook for making the tribe easier. I've met a lot of beautiful people on social media and have been able to tribe with them, so it's been awesome. So last question, I'm not going to even look to my left because somebody might raise their hand, which is a good thing, it's a good thing. So last question is, how has the Blogalicious tribe inspired you with your own tribe?
Oh my God, I don't know if I can do this sitting down. Tribe doesn't have to look like you.
Yes.
Tribe does not have to look like you, Denene. So, yeah, you needed Denene to understand raising African-American sons. I needed Denene to understand raising white sons. So I have this thing when certain kind of political, racial things are going on, I go, WWDT. What would Denene think? So then I go on my Facebook, and I'm like, it's been 17 minutes, she hasn't written anything.
Denene is popping off at the mouth, as usual.
But usually it's within 4 minutes. So she doesn't know this because it's all virtual, but she has been a member of my tribe to help me understand things in these last years. The Blogalicious tribe, again, I didn't necessarily seek out that tribe. So what I mean by saying is tribe doesn't have to look like you, and it's really important that you think like this. Sisterhood is powerful, sisterhood is important, but I didn't, in building my business, I don't know if I should say this, having somebody like Stacey Ferguson that knew a hustle in a different way than my white girlfriends knew a hustle was really powerful. And it was the hustle I needed at that time. Because the struggle of launching a business in 2009 was a little bit different. And I needed somebody like Stacey Ferguson, Stacey, and we've been through it. We've been through the trenches and the whole husband thing, that's a whole other thing. You know, building a business with a husband on the side, you know. So having that, I'm so glad it's not here. So it was important. And I didn't realize that, but it was important for me that by just picking tribe members that looked like me, I was not getting elevated the way I needed to be. And people that didn't look like me brought something to the build of my business that was so powerful. Now, same is true for white men. I picked some white men to be in my tribe because I knew that to win in Atlanta with corporate clients, I need those tribe members. Now, I approach them a completely different way. But I brought them into my tribe, I asked them to be part of my tribe, and then I asked them for help at specific times. So I think it's important when you think about tribe, don't just look for the people that look like you. Stepping outside your comfort zone. And even, you know, the early year of Blogalicious, I was, you know, I was one of the few white chicks, but I was welcomed. Very much so. And then once I was able to open my heart to realize that this is a community that's going to give to me, I mean, I feel like the Everywhere Society tribe, the Blogalicious tribe, I love you, Stacey. Thank you.
Yes.
All day long, for no good reason. Well, actually, it's a very good reason. I have about 5 more Saturdays before I send my daughter off to college. Aww. And there are days when it feels like someone's taking my heart from my body. Today it's one of those. And but my job is a storyteller, right? And I paint pictures with words, thank you. And when the first Blogalicious was created, when we had the first Blogalicious, Stacey had the first Blogalicious, I was the keynote speaker. And the same way that I feel today is the same way that I felt when I was standing up at that podium talking about my mom. I don't know if any of you guys were there, but it was here in Atlanta, and I had planned on talking about, I planned on talking about, but when I went up to the podium, I wanted to talk about my mother. She had passed away, and I missed her. It's one of those days where I just missed her. And the same way that I'm feeling right now is the way that I felt at that podium, and the power of the emotions and the connection that we had with one another as mothers, as black women, as lovers, wives, friends, strong women, weak women sometimes, in need of a hand, in need of a shoulder. That was magical to me, you know, in that moment when I wanted to paint pictures with my words and the emotions took over. And so Blogalicious, in terms of building a tribe, has been paramount in creating that space where we could connect with one another and tell those stories and feel those emotions and be okay on the other side of it, right? I'm so sorry for this, but that's the way Blogalicious makes me. Thank you, Stacey, for making me cry. But that's the way Blogalicious is for me as a tribe. Being able to connect with people that I don't know. I can see you coming in. We're standing in this space right now. We know each other from online, but you know, like we may not see each other, but every 6 months or every year at Blogalicious, but we have that connection. So thank you for that, Stacey.
Mm-hmm. Awesome. Wow. So, you know, it makes me really proud to work for a company that truly supports this sort of organization, to be able to sponsor it. And for me, it's my first experience with Blogalicious was an eye opener because, you know, for Coca-Cola, we're just, most people see us as just a brand, but to be able to relate it to something that is, and to support something that's full of diversity and what we try to represent as a company, it's just been amazing. I feel so blessed to have been introduced and to be a part of that culture, to be able to do that. And again, with Blogalicious, my experience with it, just meeting just phenomenal women. And to have so many women that look like me that I can learn, to continue to learn from and continue to always be proud of. I feel blessed in that aspect. So that's what Blogalicious has been for me, is giving that peace to be able to relate to and be proud that we're proud of.
Awesome.
So Blogalicious really came into my life as a project. And particularly for our client Toyota, we activate several sponsorships for them every single year. But I have to say being at Blogalicious was different. It touched me personally. There is something about that conference, and I love the size of it, Stacy, Cara. I hope that it never gets too big. I'm not trying to mess with your revenue. But there's such a strong feeling of family when you're there. Like you said, Danica, you felt welcome. You feel welcome immediately. And it is a well-oiled machine, I have to say that. It's definitely a well-oiled machine. But everyone talks to each other and learns from each other and inspires each other. When you leave there, you truly are excited to go on and do that next thing. So for me, it inspired me to up my hustle as well. Looking at these social media influencers, a lot who have left jobs to pursue a passion and turn the passion into profit. I mean, I've been running my agency for 17 years. And you know, with any business, you have peaks and valleys, and sometimes you love it, you're like, yay! And some days you're like, I don't wanna do this no more. So you have to find ways to recharge yourself. And after the first Blogalicious and hearing different stories and looking at success stories, I mean, Denene, I've been following you forever, and talking about you on client meetings before we even started talking to social media influencers and y'all getting paid. Trust me, I had to explain that to clients why y'all getting paid. So looking at how people really said, this is important to me. Black parenting is important to me. So I love what I do in marketing communications, but I had to ask myself, what is it about it that I love? And how can I fulfill a passion for me and make a difference through what I do? So every day when I go into the office, it's not really about, okay, I gotta crank out another press release, or call another media outlet. First of all, I specialize in multicultural communications. So what's important to me is that these big companies and big brands pay attention to people that look like us. That's what I think about every day when I'm in office. Then I think about the people that work for me and wanting them to live the lives that they live. So again, for me, it was a broader kind of story and different kind of revelations that I got from the session. And then spending time with Stacy and talking to Stacy and learning about her journey, for me, it's just really been an inspiration. But then I've also gotten small things out of, like outcomes out of it. Danica and I are friends because Stacy and I introduced us when she talked about having tribes and people of color. Danica and I had dinner, what, 3 weeks ago?
Yeah.
Maybe 3 weeks ago? I was like, oh my God, we have to do it again. Because as agency owners, we have things in common. So we were like bouncing things off each other. How do you do this? How do you do that? And you need that. So I definitely agree with you.
And the temptation would be competition.
Right.
But no, we would
not at all.
In it.
Yeah.
In it.
Yes.
And
sharing.
Yeah, sharing.
Yes.
How do you do this? How do you do that? And that's like finding those specific tribes. And I mean, we were just like,
right, definitely.
Share.
I completely agree with you. So yes, you do have to have the different tribes. And like I said, for me, it's about filling that community, but finding people that you can grow and learn from. And again, they don't always look like you. You need people who have a different kind of mindset to learn from, you know? So Blogalicious, again, for me, the main thing is I've just really, really been inspired in looking at how I conduct business differently and really looking at what is it that I need personally to do what I need to do professionally. So thank you, Stacy, and the Blogalicious team.
Yes, round of applause.
Thank you, guys. So this has been amazing. Yes. This has been an amazing panel. We'll take one question because we're on time. Let me, but I want your question. Come on.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah, of course. You did not know what you're supposed to introduce yourself.
Sure, I'm Nina Lewis, and my business is Kinkless. It's nice, it's not really a question, so I feel like I'm kind of wasting your last question. I just wanted to say that I am so inspired by being here. This is my first event. I've never been to anything like this. I kind of signed up on a whim, and then I was like, I got here, and everyone's being so inviting. And to Danica's point, my tribe in England doesn't look like me. I have people of all different races. It's very multicultural and very different. And if you look at my Facebook, I'm in the United Nations. But then I come here and it's like, it's not like that. It's all one something or all one something. It's like, pick a side. And so everything that you guys have said really resonated with me because, you know, I really truly believe that you learn from each other, from like you know, from like, you know, collaborating and really trying to understand where people are coming from. One of the biggest frustrations I find here is that people aren't willing to really listen. They have a point of view. We can have different views, but if you listen to one another, you usually find there's a common goal or common something in there that you can work from, and then move forward from a place of understanding and respect. But that never usually comes about. So everything you guys just said in that last question and the answers, I just absolutely loved and it resonated with me. So thank you.
Awesome.
So hashtag tribe up is the theme for Blogalicious 9. Hashtag Blogalicious 9 is where we want you to, the hashtag we want you to use for all your pictures. So before you go, as we end, we want to make sure that you guys take pictures with new tribe people, new people that you meet, and make sure that you connect with somebody. Did you want to go?
Yeah, there's one more thing to say, which is that this to me is what the Blogalicious tribe is all about. And if this is a taste in about 25 minutes of what you'll get over 2 days, this is just the tip of the iceberg. So right now, I want to look out to this tribe, and it's time to get serious. If you're serious about the growth of your business, if you're serious about the growth of your blog, you invest. How do you invest? You pull out your wallet. Now, there's this kind of perception that there's going to be tickets available for Blogalicious. This year, there are not. They're going back to Miami. It's going to sell out. And I do not want anybody calling me and saying, I'm in Miami, I'm in Blogalicious. Do you have any spare tickets? Because I'm not giving any tickets away, aside from today. If you commit today to buying a ticket to Blogalicious, I will match that and buy a ticket for your bestie. Everywhere Society believes so much in Blogalicious. Just one of you has to commit. The first one to go to Cara and commit gets a ticket for their bestie.
Right, let's do it.
Okay, we got one. So, the rest of you, it is such a small investment for such huge return, not to mention the whole vibe, which Cara, I mean, not only did they pick the most gorgeous hotels, but they pick the most gorgeous hotels and then Cara does her whole kind of like, the vibe. So, anyway, I will see you at Blogalicious. I would not miss a Blogalicious. I plan my year around Blogalicious, and I'm so grateful for all of you for coming today. Cara, did you want to say hi?
Yeah. So really quick, before we leave, since Danica is talking about all kinds of vibing, she is actually going to be one of our speakers, and she's just now hearing this for the first time. Talking about finding the right vibe for the tribe you want to be there. And like she said, all the feels that you have felt today, the goosebumps, the little bit of tear that wanted to trickle down your eye, but you didn't want to mess up your makeup because it's already running down your face, the smiles, the friendliness, you know, the camaraderie, the tribe, that is all there at Blogalicious and so much more. I am so proud. Every time I go and I see our community and how we turn up and turn out, how we love each other, how we care for each other, how we support each other. And like Danica said, if you want to build your business, you need to be there. You need to be there. I do myriad of conferences and summits and all that, and there is nothing like the feel of Blogalicious anywhere. And so I want to encourage you to make the commitment. Do it today. Don't wait till tomorrow. Something's going to come up. You're going to get in your car. Soon as you're behind, hit the seat, you're going to forget. Do it today. Break out your phone today and commit to going, commit to growing yourself, commit to growing your business. It'll be well worth it, and then some. Not to mention, we have a hell of a party. So, I want to thank you guys all for coming. I again want to thank Coca-Cola for sponsoring. I also want you to use their hashtag, share a Coke, along with our hashtag, Blogalicious9. And I want you guys to mix and mingle, have some more trad punch, because it is everything. And enjoy the rest of your time here. Thank you all for being here. I appreciate it so much. and Stacy does as well, and the rest of our team, and we look forward to seeing you guys all in Miami. Okay? Thank you.
Table.